Hello, YouTubers. Reloading Bench back with you once again. We are going to see if the old adage of fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on me, comes true today. So for those of you who remember, this is my made in Germany. Where's it at? I don't know. Can you see that? This is my not made in Germany steel, who knows what size file it is, with no branding, labeling, or whatever. So since I'm a glutton for punishment, this came, and we will be opening it. All the other side has my info, so I'm not turning that over. I like my privacy. No doxing. Oh, it's like semi-opened anyway. Ah. Okay, so this came in a box. This one did not. I'm a little scared to flip over the box. Okay. So it says steel 2-in-1, easy file, chainsaw, sharpener, 0.325, new. All right, here we go. Here's the fool me once, shame on you. Drum roll, please, fool me twice. Uh-oh. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so I'm already seeing positive because that looks gray and this looks white. I'm seeing some embossing. So we're going to flip it over. Oh, yeah. So, yep, okay. So far, so good. I still don't know if it's a copy. So, again, the colors, a more subdued orange and a very, light gray versus, this looks like a dreamsicle from the supermarket. This looks like a tool. And you'll notice, let me pull the faker out. Let's see how good of a fakery. Let's line it up. What do we have here? Okay, so let's see how good the fakery looks. So right here on the, okay, let me pull it out of the sleeve. Okay, so had the knockoff, this is what I was looking for, the made in Germany embossing. I don't know if the camera's picking that up. And the steel name that is absent from the fakery. And again, the colors are different. So in terms of markings, these are identical. You can see the quality of the craftsmanship or lack of. The German version, very precise in the plastics. The Chinese version, kind of shitty. no other way to put it. This side. I guess looks a little better. So immediately, you can see. So as I hold this in my hand, the gaps in the spacing on the real steel and then the spacings, I mean, Jesus, look at that. It's not even fucking close. I mean, look at the gaps. That is just amazing. So yeah, same housing sizes. But I mean, when you look at, again, real on the left, fake on the right, things just aren't in the right places. They're not the right sizes. They don't have the right spacing. When you look at this file here, it's different than sizing on this file. Both of these look so tiny. And these do not. That's, yeah. So if this one's a fake, it's a better fake than this one. And again, I'm feeling a little better about the potential fakery because, again, it says 0.325, 4.8 millimeter. What was this one? 4.0 millimeter. Again, I have no idea how true. Looks like, and again, you can tell. Again, steel labeling versus not. That's just too funny. Too funny. Too Chinese funny. All right. So yeah, I had a big feeling that this was completely untrustworthy in terms of sizing and material and spacing and everything. Zero trust. And there shouldn't be because it's a knockoff. And oh yeah, just the feel. Completely, yeah. Yeah, fakery, fakery, fakery duck. That's fucking funny. Such a shame. You have to be so careful. So, still pursuing all my goodies in terms of refund. Amazon's working on it, so not worried about it. Counterfeit, always a no-go. And just funny how the counterfeiter is complaining about it's too expensive to return this. Maybe they should think twice about selling counterfeit goods. So, good stuff. Fool me once, shame on you, and no fool me twice. So, happy camper. Good stuff, Steel. Thanks.